Hi everyone, in this video we are going to talk about some graphical tools for categorical data. And the data I prepared here is from Open Intro, and we are actually looking at college students of their genders and also whether they are looking for a spouse in college or not. So we have gender, female and male, and we have spouse, yes or no. And we have a total number of cons for each combination. And first of all, I imported the data by running the code, or you can just click the file, import dataset from text, because the data I prepared is a CSV file. So you can just click import dataset from text, text base. That's good. And then you may want to get the variable names down in the console so that you can use it, and you can just copy and paste the variable names. The first thing we can do is to check the number of students for each gender, like how many girls we have, how many boys we have. Right, so to do that we are going to use a function called ggplot, and this function is from a package called ggplot2, a very popular package, and I want you to install the packages if you are using it for the first time. So you can click install.packages and use a double quotation mark and type ggplot2 within it. So you can run this line and it will start installing the package. And once it is installed, you can just use library on ggplot2. So this function is to load the package. So you can use that function within the package. And the first parameter we want to put in for this ggplot function is the dataset name. And the second thing we want to specify is called AES. So you can see it here. AES is the aesthetic mapping describing how variables in the data are mapped to visual properties. So in the AES, we are going to use a pair of parentheses, and we are going to specify Y to be the numerical values, which we named it as total. And X should be gender, because we are looking at the categorical variable about number of students for each gender. So after it, we type plus, and then we can use GEOM bar so that we are specifying we are drawing a bar plot. But you don't want to run this code right now because you didn't specify which value or how you are going to use the value. Like you get an error message there. So here we want to specify stat equals identity. So that means whatever value we have, we are just going to use that value to draw our bar plot like this. So you're actually seeing female is, we have much more females than males in the data. And another way to think about, so this is just a bar plot, right? So the second plot we can check is to think about the yes and no in different genders in the data. So we want to consider both the categorical variables and the total numbers. So we can do ggplot, gender, spouse, and then still we specify AES and X. And one more thing we want to add here is called fill. We let it to be the second variable we have is called spouse. We want it to be this variable here. And after specify, we are going to draw a bar plot. And again, you want to let it to be identity. And you can run these two lines and then see what we have. So looking at this graph here, we are actually having gender, female and male, and we also have the spouse and the yes and no answers stacked up. So you can see we have more yes answers for female than male, and we also have more no answers for female comparing with male, because we have more female data comparing with male data. So this information might not be helpful by stacking them up. Another thing you can do is to check the yes, no answer in different gender in percentage. Like how percent you have for yes answers for female, and how would you compare that number for those for the percentage number for male. So I'm going to copy everything here, and I'm going to change the position into fill. So that means I'm going to fill up the bars, and but those bars will be filled up according to yes no answers. So let's run this and see. So you can see here we have 100%, 0 to 100%, and we have female is about, so this is 25, so that is about 37, and for male we have about 25 or 26, so they are kind of close, right? And then you can also, sometimes you may want to make side by side bars. So let me show you how to make that kind of graph. So you can copy everything here. You are not going to change anything here, but you are going to change the position into dots. So you run this, and you can see the graph is like a side by side bar.